friends, I am Yogesh.
I am Arpit.
In a last class, we had seen the timer. So we had discussed in detail the timer, like how it works, and many other detail we had discussed. And like we had seen many doubts normally people are asking. We had seen some internal thing, then how timer works and all other thing we had seen. So in today class, we are going to write the program. So like in timer program,
sir, can you tell me in brief, like what is timer?
We had discussed in a previous video. If you want, you can watch the previous video in detail. I'll try to explain briefly here, and then like we'll move forward.
Thank you.
So like in timer, what is the timer? Is like say, we are having a crystal oscillator. This crystal oscillator is like, you can see our schematic of this board, you will understand. This crystal oscillator is 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, so this crystal oscillator, if you can see our board, M5 board, and in there you will get this crystal, this much frequency crystal is there. This microcontroller, how this crystal frequency comes, it comes like this. It will be 1 volt peak to peak signal like that. It's very weak signal, 1 volt peak to peak signal is coming. Then this signal is passes through the PLL. So that internally we are having here the PLL, microcontroller having PLL. What this PLL do is it convert the pulse like this. So it's a 5 volt, 0 volt, like that it will convert. So here the frequency of this also will be same, megahertz only. Now what happen is, this controller inside it taking, okay, so this, when we pass through this crystal frequency to the PLL, it will convert like this. And internally this crystal is taking 12 cycle, so divide by 12. So if you divide this frequency by 12, it will come around 9 to 1.6 kilohertz. This is the actual frequency on which this controller is working. So how this, if you plot this frequency, it will become something like this. So in one second, this many cycles are coming. In 1 second, this many cycles are coming. So if I ask, One cycle how much time is taking? So what you can do, you maybe know the formula, frequency is equal to 1 upon time, time is equal to 1 upon frequency. Just divide this by 1 by, so let's say time is equal to 1 upon frequency. So if you do 1 upon 9 to 1.6 kilohertz, if you do that, you will get 1.08 microsecond. Okay, I can show this thing quickly for you. So consider like we went here. And like we are having 11.0592, this is megahertz, divide by 12. So this will be 921.6 kilohertz frequency will get, and 1 upon 921.6. So 921.6 kilohertz, if you do, it will coming around 1.08 microseconds. So that is what I had wrote here. Fine. So what's the meaning of this? 1.08 microsecond? The meaning of 1.08 microsecond is, for every cycle it take 1.08 microsecond. It means once you start timer, it will count. It will count whatever you say, it will start. After 1.8 microsecond, it will go next. After 1.8 microsecond, it go next. After 1.8 microsecond, it go next. It's like that. And in timer, we are having two register. We are having two register, that is TH0 and TL0. This is 8-bit two register. Both are 8-bit. So total 16-bit register. Consider if you wrote FFFC. In last example also, I wrote this. After 1.08 microsecond, it will automatically, of course you have to do the setting, automatically it will go to FFFD. Then after 1.08 microsecond, it will go to FFFE. After 1.80 microsecond, it will become FF. After this, this will become 0000 if you add 1 in it. And this place, we will get the one flag that TF0 will become 1. In all other place, this TF0 will be 0. All other place TF0 will be 0. Only when we are moving from here to here, then it become like 1. So this setting, how much this delay it's giving? 1 microsecond, 2 microsecond, 3 microsecond, 4 microsecond. So if you want 4 microsecond delay, you have to write this value. Don't think you have to write 0004 for 4 microsecond. It's not like that. If you write this, then it will be start and it will go till maximum and then it will become FF and then it become 0. That much delay it will give. So this delay will be huge. Okay, huge means around 70-71 millisecond kind of delay you will be getting. So hope you understanding like what is timer and how it taking crystal input and it calculating the time. So hope you understand. So we will start writing now program. Okay, so here when we write program, one first thing come T mode. So I will start writing. We'll make one project also here, new project. Our microcontroller, so we can select microcontroller as W78E052D. You can select this. Okay, start a file we don't want. Here we'll go and add the new source item, ASM file, and we can give maybe timer 01. That's all. So we'll say ORG0, and now we have to write something in TMOD register. What is TMOD register? In previous class we had seen that also TMOD register. I'll again try to explain it, and this calculation also I need it in 2 minutes. So meanwhile I'll start with TMOD first. So what is TMOD? What is TMOD register? TMOD is a 8-bit register. It is having here, this is for timer 0, this is for timer 1, this is for timer 0. It's having 4 bits. So this is T mode 0, this is T mode 1, this is C oblique T, and this is gate. So I explained in previous video properly. The gate is if we want to control our timer externally, then we make it this one. So currently we want to control internally. C oblique T means whether we want counter or timer. So we want timer, so we'll make it 0. T mode 0 and this. What we can write here? 00011011. So this is 13-bit mode, this is 16-bit mode. So we will use our timer currently in 16-bit mode like this. So we will be writing 00001 and then this 4-bit we can write 00. So in T mode register, we have to write in 0 and 1 in hexadecimal. This is in binary. In hexadecimal, what you have to write? 0 cross 01. This is in hex, this is in binary. Fine. So now here in T mode, or we can write directly, you can say move T mode comma hash 001H. Done. So T mode is done. Now we have to write the TH0 TL0. Now I'll explain how to calculate TH0 TL0. Consider we want 5 millisecond delay. Consider we want 5 millisecond delay. 5 milli means 5000 microseconds. This much delay we want, and one cycle gives delay of 1.08 microsecond. So let's divide here, 5000 divided by 1.08 microsecond. So once we divide it, we will get the count. Let's see how much count we are getting. So 5000 divided by 1.08, it's coming 4692. Fine. So it's coming 4692. This many count we need to generate this much of millisecond. Okay. Now what we have to write. In the previous section I told, the main signal we are getting when we are rollover from FF to 00, when we are getting rollover here, that time we are getting the signal. It means if we want this much of count, we have to go back from this much backside. Okay, but remember, this number is in decimal, this number is in hex, so you have to do in one language you can convert. Okay, I mean one language you can do calculation. So consider I'll do in hexadecimal. So this FFFFFF, if you convert in hexadecimal, this comes 65535 minus 4692, that will come. So 65535 minus 4692. So it's coming this much. 60843. If I convert this 60843 into hexadecimal, so decimal number will be 60843. So it's coming EDAB. So this I have to write in TH0, this I have to write in TL0, like this. Okay, now that's all. So your 5 millisecond delay you got. Let's write this thing EDAB. So we'll write here move TH0 comma H0 ED move TL0 comma H0 EB. Yeah, so we now wrote the value. What value we need, we written inside it. Now what we have to do is, now we have to do one more setting. Let's go here. So this two setting we had done. Now this is our flag and we have to start the timer, that's all. So I will explain this thing again. So what we have to do now, or I'll write code here. So what we have to do, clear clr TF0. This flag is already clear. We are just clearing one more time. So now this is clear, and then we have to start the timer. So how to start timer? Set bit, and then TR0. That's all. Sorry, I wrote ACT bit set. Fine. Now our timer is all setting done, and timer is started also. Timer is started also. So now if we have to check the how it is, means whether my timer is completed or not. So how to check completed or not? We can say jump if not bit, because until unless this bit is clear, it means my timer is going on. So we can say TF0 comma L1. And what is L1? I'll write it. It means what? Until unless this bit is 0, we will be looping here only, like that. Once it complete, it means my timer is over. So let's move maybe P0 comma hash 000H. So we clear the port, and then of course this flag is got set, that also we need to clear TF0. Now so one round is completed here. Now we have to do for second round. So for that, again we can do the setting TH0 TL0. We can write it here like this. Then this clear flag we already done, this we no need to do again and again, and that's all. We have to say the loop. So now what we had done, so what we did here, again we started the timer again with this value, and after once timer is over, we will make it FF. So hope you understand what I did. I did the setting, and then I started my timer. So I can say like start timer. This is clear flag. This two value is for 5 millisecond. Okay, same thing. And then we are making it port. Make port 0, that's all. And then Then again we started timer and then we are making it port high. That's all. This activity we have to do again and again. So we can say jump, maybe start, and we can start from here. Done. Our program is ready. I'll just write end statement and done. So save, compile. We don't have any error. Go here, output, create hex file, build it. Our hex file is created. Let's download. So you can go and select the file. So this is our file just now we created. And we'll say upload in hardware. Just we have to reset the our hardware. See, uploading is done. And now after that I had already connected with the logic analyzer. Let's run the device and wow. So see, our we are getting our 5 millisecond exactly. 5 millisecond we are getting. See, we are getting little more here, 5.1 millisecond. Reason being like we are having some extra instruction. So once it finishing we are making it port high. And then we are getting little extra time to go back and proceed. So this two instruction is also taking the time into consideration. So due to that, like some we are getting little extra time. So that is okay. That you can adjust the time. You can you can reduce little bit this delay and you can get it. Okay. So hope you understand the thing and you do the assignment and. So friend, you had seen like we had achieved the 5 millisecond delay here. And if you have any doubt, any query, you can ask me.
Sir, I have one query.
Yeah, tell me.
We got 5.1 microsecond delay, something.
No, millisecond.
Millisecond.
5.1
millisecond. So what we can do to get exact 5 millisecond? Is there any
way? Yeah. See, what we had done is currently we for calculation how we had done is we had ignored one data so that we can take it into consideration.
Mm-hmm.
Then you will get completely 5 millisecond. I'll show it here.
Okay.
So say if you are having a 11.0592 megahertz divided by 12, so it's coming 921.6 and 1 upon 921.6 if you do, so it's coming 1.085. so this 5 is also having significant role.
Mm-hmm.
So we in our calculation what we did, we used 1.08 only. So due to this 5 also it impacting. I'll show you the calculation.
Okay.
Consider like say if you want 5000 count you want, 5000 millisecond you want, to you divide by 1.08. If you do by 8, you are getting this one, 4692. But that we had done previously.
Yes.
But if you want exact delay, then you have to consider that also, and it will become 1.085. If you do this, it coming 4608.
Mm-hmm.
So 4608, if you go in programmer calculator, 4608, so 65535 minus 4608, if you do it coming EDFF. So if you go here.
Mm-hmm.
You see our value is changing, EDFF. Here also it coming EDFF. So what is the changes is coming? Earlier in our previous calculation we use 1.08, but actually it is 1.085. so due to this 5 is impacting.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do now, it become FF. If we calculate, if we put this, let's upload this program. So we build, go here, load the file, take the file, upload file, reset the board. Then if you come here and run, it's getting exactly now you are getting 5 milliseconds. Here also 5 milliseconds. So hope you understanding. If the so the small delay is also giving the effect. If you want exact delay, you have to consider, even you can consider more decimal point and you will get more accurate delay. So hope it making sense. Guys, if you want to purchase this board, you can go to the given website. You can visit it there. You can write a mail to us or you can contact us. You do the practice. See, embedded is full of practice. If you are watching, just watching video will may not help you. You have to do the practice. And this boards comes with all accessories you need to learn. Even each and everything, whatever you require to learn embedded system is come with everything. And so apart from that, you can have a board and enjoy the learning, and we are providing here entire thing for you. So we are available for you, and we will do few more program in assembly, and then we will move into C. Assembly is a more closest thing what we can do in a assembly. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a nice day.
Thank you.